Well, here's an interesting tidbit of news. Facebook heading for its worst trading day ever. Apparently, lack of trust in Facebook has led to lower than expected revenues. They're not going out of business, folks. This company is just entirely too big. A juggernaut, if you will. But it is interesting to note that they are stumbling a little bit. For those of you who have my Facebook and my YouTube, and that's not too many because I don't really... I always kept my social media account somewhat separate. But if you wondered why I haven't been posting on Facebook too much, I think I've only actually put 2 posts on throughout the entire month of July. This is why. People are just getting away from it. I'm just trying to get away from social media in general. It just takes up too much time. I think I'll probably just stick to YouTube because it's more of a creative outlet for me. But as far as Facebook goes and the rest, I don't know. I like Twitter because I can yell at people directly, but, other than that, yep. So here you go, sign of the times, Facebook just getting a little stumble on the old stock market. Oh, how you doing, YouTubers? Here at North River TV. Let's make a video, shall we? Got this old crusty stereo here. I have no idea how this thing ended up in my hoard, but here it is. I actually had to look for the model tag to figure out what this was. It's an Arvin package stereo from probably the mid-70s, I would say. Came with a couple of speakers. Pretty typical of mid-70s stereos. Have 5 1/4 drivers in them. But I have no idea if this works or not. I've not touched it. I haven't even cleaned it. But we do have it plugged in. And let's... see what it does. Crunchy on the controls, and every light is burned out.
And all that belongs to heaven now belongs to you, because all that belongs to you now belongs to him. And there's a covenant cut between God and man. When the Lord Jesus Christ instituted the Lord's Supper, that Last Supper, the Lord Jesus took that cup and he held it up, and this is what
it is. Our kid, any kid you know, by visiting b95.com.
MGM Resorts believes New England deserves more than your typical casino, like a dynamic and lively dining, gaming, and entertainment district opening August 24th at...
Signing up for M Life Rewards. I'm actually kind of surprised this works.
So random acts of flying is through fly92.com.
Tracks to test with this thing. It's probably a good thing.
Oh.
AM radio.
No.
Let's face it, we take our hands for granted every day. The truth is, you know...
...structure of government and law.
For Thanksgiving, like...
You forget that you too...
Maybe higher. The question is, well, how will Turkey fund that deficit? And
so we've established that it works, and the tuner works, and both channels work. Alright, what do I do with a $10 stereo that nobody wants? Well, if I were a person of better judgment, I would haul this thing right out to the curb. Let's open it up. I'm curious to see what's inside it. Well, I couldn't help but clean it up a little bit. And as you can see, it looks almost exactly the same. But figured I'd take a couple of layers of Hantavirus and a couple more layers of tobacco off of it. I mean, you know. This is what came off of it, just with a light cleaning. And, it doesn't look any different. Anyhow. Alright, let's pull this thing apart, see what's inside.
Well, they say we're supposedly having a drought this year, but, every day for the last, I don't know, 4 or 5 days, it's just done nothing but, get these downpours where you get like half an inch to an inch of rain in like 10 minutes. There's no shortage of water here in New York, that is for sure.
And for reference, it's an Arvin ADL-33 walnut vinyl veneer. Ooh, fancy. To prevent electric shock, do not remove screws. Hey, guess what? Let's remove the screws. You know, it absolutely shocks me that even the cheapest electronics of the 1970s were still better built than anything today. I mean, this says, what, walnut vinyl veneer on it, but yet it's still made out of real wood. Not the best quality stuff, but it's still real wood underneath this thing. And even the bottom of it is real wood. Of course, the back of its press board, like any other vintage radio would be of the era. But, still, I mean, it never ceases to amaze me. Alright, here's our 8-track player here. This is a fairly robust chassis, and this thing is not light, to say the least. And I really don't want to mess up this dial string too badly, so I have to handle this gingerly, as they say. Let's flip it over. Alright, looking at the guts in this thing. 8-track player, of course. belt driven. Looks like a motor that could probably power a modern washing machine. I wonder if it works. Let's see here. I wonder if we... Oops. Hang on. Alright. I think this switch probably turns it on. Oh, we have power. Let's see. Where's the... Program solenoid's obviously working, but we don't know what program we are in because those lights don't work, or dial lights don't work. Okay, I'll turn you off for a minute. Let's see what we got here. Well, looks like a two-gang tuner. Power distribution. This is a transformer set with the voltages actually labeled on the transformer. Primary 24.5 volts, 6 volt secondary. There's your AM and FM tuner. I'm not sure what this board is. I'm guessing it's stereo multiplex or something to do with it. And this is the audio output, the amplifier. And that's it. Pretty straightforward. Curious why we don't have lights. That goes straight to the transformer, and this comes over to here, to that tap. Let's get a voltage check. Positive on the lead coming straight off the transformer, and the negative back on that power distribution strip thing there, whatever. We have 6.8 volts, which is exactly what we're supposed to have. And all of these bulbs are wired in parallel, and we have voltage to every one of them. If I just simply go down the line, and right there. So, wow, can all these lights be blown? Hey, look, kids, plastic straw in a plastic cup with a plastic lid. Why outlaw the plastic straw and keep the plastic cup? I don't know, but thank God this isn't California. Anyhow, one of my favorite bits about going to the parts house here is get everything in a nice little paper bag. But where did he put it in here? A handwritten receipt. When's the last time you saw a handwritten receipt for stuff? You know? Absolutely fantastic. I'm so glad that this gentleman is still in business, because we would be screwed here locally without it. no Radio Shack. Fry's won't move anywhere near the Northeast. And there's just nowhere to get parts. So I'm glad these little parts houses are still around. Anyway, it's time to get some GMO and get back on this project. Okay, back from the parts house. These little sockets are not easy to get out, but it's a number 40 dial lamp, which is pretty much the same rating as a 47, but it's got a screw base instead of a bayonet. Anyway, changed it. Let's see if it works. There we go. All right, well, three more of these babies to change out. Every one of them was burned out, so either this is a really high hour set, or it took one hell of a surge at some point.
The benefits of trade between countries.
Oh, okay, we got the dial lights in. Looks a little better. Dial's actually pretty accurate.
And we see some increased traffic on Route 7 heading over westbound over the river into Green Island. Give yourself a little extra time as you head in those directions.
I'm not sure if this is just an old school.
Westbound getting into Schenectady via I-90.
I don't know if this is just an old school FM tuner or what. It's only a 2-gang tuner. I don't expect miracles from it, but of course you gotta break a bulb when you change them. Seems like it needs an alignment, but I don't have the oscilloscope to do that. So I think I'm just gonna leave well enough alone. Dial's pretty accurate. Sounds pretty decent. It's not receiving terribly bad. Especially with nothing hooked up to the antenna. All right. Doesn't even really need a recap either. I mean, it seems all the functions are pretty solid on this thing. I don't know what kind of... this is a very Japanese-y set, but I have no idea who ultimately made it. That's pretty much who makes the caps in this thing. Escon. Not sure who made that. That's the proper date code. This is from, 1970 or thereabouts? So. Maybe 71? That would jive with the design of this, for sure. And the fact that it's an Arvin. I mean, when's the last time you've seen one of these things? An Arvin, especially with let me move that out of the way. With the newer style logo. I shouldn't say newer, I should say the last style logo, because Arvin disappeared very shortly after the early 70s. I think the mid 70s, they were pretty much toast. But I feel like taking this a step further. Oh, you know what's cool? Here's the wiring harness for the audio controls for the 8-track tape player. And it just goes right into an old school tape connector. They didn't even hardwire it. It just plugs in. Look at that. Isn't that cool? I'm really thinking about deleting this 8-track and putting something a bit more modern in this space. I gotta contemplate this for a minute.
Well, now here's a story that you don't see every day. Perhaps a little bit of honesty in the press, huh? Amazon facial recognition thinks 28 congressmen look like known criminals at default settings. And congressmen are not happy about it. I don't know. Might actually be working pretty good, if it's truly honest.
Okay, well, after looking at this a little longer, I've decided that we are not going to pull the 8-track player. The 8-track player, the motor, it's all powered by 120 volts straight up. And it's just, I could pull this, but I wouldn't be able to utilize the space as I originally thought. So, for the purists out there, rest easy, we're not going to wreck this thing. We did come up with a solution, however, to make this a little more up to date. Okay, switched outlet. And we will just take this, plug that in like that. You can see the little, well, I don't know if you can see that or not, the little blue light is blinking in there. And we will plug these into the aux jacks. Not sure if I have that balanced out right. And that's it. This is just stuff I had laying around in my parts stash. Except for the Bluetooth adapter. But these, I kind of picked up like half a dozen of them from one of the Chinesium dealers, Banggood or AliExpress or something. These were only a couple of bucks a piece. So I picked up a bunch of them, and I haven't used any of them. So, but here's a good place to try it out. Okay, I don't know if you can hear that. That's the reason why I did not hardwire the Bluetooth unit into where the 8-track would go permanently, because it completely takes out the AM reception. So at least this way I can unplug it if I want to listen to AM radio. So we'll go over to aux. And I've already paired the Bluetooth receiver. So I think some Escavel is in order. And that's it. So we brought this old Arvin into modern day use. That's it from North River TV. Have a good one.
As 24% in after-hours trading yesterday, that fall wiped out roughly $150 billion of its market value.